for class 3. Yes, how are you all students? Yes, I know that you all are fit and fine and you all are safe at your homes. Yes or no? Yes, everybody is staying at home. Why everybody is staying at home? To keep themselves or keep ourselves safe. Safe from what? What is the situation that we are facing? Yes, it is the pandemic of COVID-19. We all are calling it as coronavirus. So what we people are doing? We are keeping ourselves safe. So today's topic is lesson number 6, keeping safe. So students, we are going to learn the new lesson, that is keeping safe. What is the meaning of keeping safe? What do you understand by the word safe? Yes, keeping safe means we are going to stay away from any injury or from any harmful incident. Yes, so we are going to learn some safety measures, some preventive measures so that we don't get any hurt or any injury. So let us start with the lesson, that is keeping safe. Now open your page number 56. On page number 56, learning checklist is given. Means what points we are going to discuss in this lesson. So what is the first point? Yes, the first point is safety at home and school. The first point is safety at home and school. We are going to learn about how we are going to prevent ourselves or how we are going to keep ourselves safe at home and at school. The second is safety at road and in the playground. Second one is safety at on the road and on the playground. You people are going, you are going on the playground to play, but many times if you are not careful, what happens? You get injured. So in this lesson we are going to learn some safety measures to prevent ourselves or from getting hurt. And the third one is the first aid. The first third point that we are going to learn is first aid. What is first aid? Have you heard this word before? Yes, first aid means it is a help before we go to the doctor. If you got hurt or if you got injured, if you got injury on your hand or on your leg, what happens? When you go home, your mother washes the injured area and then she applies some antiseptic like Dettol or hand cream and she then takes you to the doctor. So this is related to first aid. So we are going to learn in detail about first aid and these three topics. Okay students, now see here on page number 56, here are some exercise, that is read the conversation given below and tick to the safe situation and cross to the unsafe situation. So the safe situation and the unsafe situation, you are grown up, you are big enough to understand what is safe situation and what is unsafe situation. So see the first boy, he is drinking something. The second boy, what does he say? I think you are drinking some medicine. Can I also taste it? The boy says, I want to taste the medicine that you are drinking. Is it safe situation or unsafe situation? Yes, it is unsafe situation. We should not take any medicine only for tasting or without any precaution of the without any permission of your elder ones or the doctor. So it is an unsafe situation. So cross it out. The second one, I always wear a helmet while skating. Is it a safe situation or unsafe? It is a safe situation. Because when you are wearing the helmet and in case you fell down, the helmet is going to prevent you or it is going to keep you safe from getting injured. So it is a safe situation. So mark a tick there. Then third boy, what does he say? I am going to the terrace to fly these balloons. He says that I am going to fly the balloons. Alone he is going on the terrace. Is it safe? No, it is not safe. It is unsafe. So cross it out. It is an unsafe situation. Next, we never forget to line up while boarding bus. Yes, when you are coming to school by the school bus, how you are going in the bus? Are you pushing one another or you are going in a line? Yes, if you are pushing one another, it is very unsafe situation. But if you are going in line, then it is a safe situation. Now these people say that they are going in line, so it is a safe situation. So put a tick there. Open page number 57. Keeping safe means staying away from harm or injury. We may get hurt or injured if we are not careful at all times. We must follow some safety rules to avoid injuries and accidents. Yes, they have given us the definition of what is the meaning of keeping safe. Keeping safe means what? Staying away from any harm or any injury. Why? We may get hurt or we may get injured when we are not careful. So, we should follow some safety rules to avoid injuries and accidents. Now, let us learn some ways to keep ourselves safe. So, first we are going to learn how we are going to keep ourselves safe in home or at home or at school. We should follow some safety rules to avoid injuries at home. The first one, do not take any medicine on your own without asking any elder or doctor. Yes, this is the very important thing. We should not take any medicine without asking your doctor or your elders. It is very harmful or it may be very dangerous. So, avoid taking medicine on your own. Do not touch electrical switches, plugs or wires with wet hands. You may get an electric shock. Yes, it's very important that when you are touching your switches, electric switches, your hands should be dry. They should not be wet. If you are touching it with wet hands, you are going to get a electric shock. So be careful, students, when you are touching the electrical switches. Third, do not fly kites on the open terrace or burst crackers near electric poles and wires. Yes, you should not go on the open terrace and to fly kites. It's very dangerous. You may fall down, you may get injured. So be careful that you are not going to fly kites on the open terrace. In the same way, do not burst crackers, fire crackers near the electric pole. It is very harmful. It may get blast. There may be blast. And you may get in a very dangerous situation. So you should not burst crackers near the electric poles. Do not play outdoor games inside the house. You or someone might get hurt. Yes, outdoor games are for playing outside. If you are playing outdoor games inside, if you are running here and there, if you are catching your friends, it is very dangerous. You may fall down or some other person may get injured. So outdoor games should be played out of the house. Next, be careful while walking on wet bathroom floor. You or someone else might slip and get hurt. Yes, when you are walking on the wet bathroom floor, you should be very careful because it may be slippery. You may fall down or you may get hurt. Do not leave toys, bags, shoes or any other thing scattered on the floor on the staircase. You or someone else might trip over them and get hurt. Yes, every time we are telling you to keep, your mother tells you to keep your bags, books, your toys in your proper place. Why she tells you? Yes, so that It is not, they are not scattered on the floor and you may not get hurt. You may trip on them, you may fall down on it and you may get hurt. So, keep your books, toys properly in their proper place. Do not play with candles and matchsticks. Yes, you should not play with candles or matchsticks. Do not go near the stove. You might get a burn. Yes, we are also telling you from many times your mother tells you not to play with the matchsticks. Don't go near the gas, near the stove. It is very harmful. Do not play with the sharp objects like scissors and knife. You might injure yourself. Yes, you should not play with the scissors and knives. They are very harmful. You may get hurt on your hand. Next, safety in school. See here. When we are in the school, we should be also careful at that times. So, what are the safety rules that we should follow? Let us learn. Do not play inside the classroom and do not throw things at others. Yes, this is the first rule that we should follow when we are in the school. When we are in the classroom, you should not play in the classroom. Every time your teacher tells you, please sit down, don't run here and there. Why she tells you? So that you should be safe. You should not get injured. You should not get hurt. So, do not play inside the classroom. And do not throw things at others. This is also very bad. If you are throwing an eraser, if you are throwing a pencil, it may get hurt. The person at which you are throwing, he or she might get hurt. Do not fight with your classmates. Do not hit or push them. Yes. This is also very, very important. Do not fight with your classmates. Do not push one another. Do not use sharp objects like blades to sharpen your pencils. Use pencil sharpeners. Yes. When you are using you want to sharpen your pencil, what you have to do? You have to use the sharpener. Don't use the blade. It is very dangerous. Do not climb on desk or benches and do not jump from one desk to another. Yes, when the teacher is not there in the class, what you people do? You jump on the desks. Many times I have found that you are jumping from one desk to another. It is also very dangerous. So avoid doing this in the class. Stand in a queue and do not push one another while getting into or down from the school bus. Yes, when you are going by bus, you should enter into the bus in line. You should not push one another. In the same way, when you are getting down from the bus, then also you are going to come outside from the bus in line. These are the safety measures which you should follow. Okay, students. Now, we will stop here. In the next video, we will continue the remaining chapter. So, what is your PH? You are going to read the lesson and see the safety measures are given to you. You have to follow them. These are very important for ourselves to keep ourselves safe and fit. So, read the lesson, follow the safety rules. Till then, stay safe and stay healthy.